Sit down, Kate, and welcome. You loggerheaded and unpolished grooms. What, no attendance, no regard, no duty? You peasant swain, you whoreson malt horse drudge! Did not I bid thee ride ahead post haste and have all things made proper for thy mistress?
Nathaniel's coat, sir, was not ready made. And Gregory's pumps were all unpinked in the heel. And Philip's dagger was not fully sheathed. As they are, here are they come to serve you.
Go, rascals, go, and fetch my supper in. Go, rascals, go, go! Food! Food!
Oh, yeah! Give me a chicken!
Food!
Things is ready.
Nay, good sweet Kate, be merry. Be merry, Kate. Some water here, what ho? Water! Water! Shall I have some water?
Water!
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 Patience, I pray you! 'Twas a fault unwilling!
Horse! Beetle-headed! Flappy-eared knave! Huh? Come, Kate, sit down.
And I know you have a stomach. Shall you give thanks, good Kate, or else shall I? Ah. Chicken?
Aye.
Who brought it?
I. 'Tis burnt! So is all of these.
Oh,
what dogs are these? Where is the rascal cook? How durst thou, Philip? Bring it on the breath and serve the customer who loves it not. Here, take it to you. I tell thee, Kate, 'twas burnt and dried away, and I expressly am forbid to touch it, for it engenders anger, planteth choler, and better 'twere that both of us did fast than feed it with such over-roasted flesh. Be patient, tomorrow it shall be mended, and for this night we'll fast for company. Come, I will bring thee to thy bridal chamber.
Bring me out.
Oh!
Fools! In what fashion have you made a bed? With here a pillow flung and there a bolster, this way the coverlet and that the sheet. How in this hurly-burly may a groom tenderly woo and win his loving bride? Gregory, Curtis, Philip, Nathaniel, Grubio! I spit on you that you should treat her thus.
This is the way to kill a wife with kindness.
Good morrow, Kate. What, sweetie, all forlorn? How fares my Kate?
Ill.
Pluck up your spirits, look cheerfully upon me. Your father bids us to Bianca's wedding, and thither must we journey, bravely clad. Tailor and haberdasher wait thy leisure to deck thy body with their ruffling treasure. Come, tailor, let us see these ornaments. What's the news with you? Sir?
Here is the cap your worship did bespeak.
Oh. Why, this was molded on a porringer.
Oh, I like the cap.
A velvetish firefight is lewd.
Lewd?
And filthy. Why, it is a cockle or a walnut shell, a knack, a toy, a trick, a baby's cap. Away with it, come. Let me see a bigger.
I'll have no bigger. This doth fit the time, and gentlewomen wear such caps as these.
When you are gentler, you shall have one too, and not before.
Why, sir, I trust I may have leave to speak, and speak I will. I am no child, no babe. Your betters have endured me. Speak my mind. And if you cannot, best you stop your ears. My tongue will tell the anger of my heart, or else my heart concealing it will break.
I love thee well, and that thou likest it not.
Love me or love me not, I like the cap, and it I will have, or I will have none.
The gown. Come, tailor, let us see it. God, what mama's stuff is here? What's this?
Worship.
The sleeve? It is like a demi-cannon. What, up and down carved like an apple tart? Why, what the devil's name, tailor, callst thou this?
You bid me make it orderly and well, according to the fashion and the time.
Oh, monstrous arrogance, thou liest! Thou thread! Thou thimble! Thou jump! Three quarters! Thou liest! Thou lapier! Quarter inch! Thou flea! Thou knit! Thou winter cricket, thou! Away! Thou rag! Thou quantity! Thou remnant! Or I shall show thee meet with thee with thy yard, as thou shalt think I'm prating while thou livest! Well, come, my Kate. We must unto your fathers, even in these honest, mean habiliments. Our purses shall be proud, our garments poor. But is the mind that makes the body rich? And as the sun breaks through the darkest cloud, so honor appeareth in the meanest habit. What, is the jay more precious than the lark because his feathers are more beautiful? Or is the adder better than the eel because his painted skin contents the eye? Oh, no, good Kate. Neither art thou the worse for this poor furniture and mean array. If thou canst it shame, blame it on me. And therefore, frolic. And now, my honey love, will we return unto your father's house
and revel it as bravely as the best. With silken coats and caps and golden rings and ruffs and cuffs and farthingales and things, with amber bracelets, beads and scarfs and fans.
When shall we leave?
Why now?
What is o'clock?
It is day.
It is night.
It is seven.
It is two at most.
It shall be seven, or I will not ride. Look, what I speak, or do, or think to do, you are still crossing of it. Nay, let it alone. I will not go today, or ere I do, it shall be what o'clock I say it is.
Tis seven.
Come on, in God's name, once more unto your fathers. Good Lord, how bright and goodly shines the moon. I say it is the moon.
I know it is the moon.
Why, then you lie, it is the blessed sun.
Then God be blessed, it is the blessed sun. But sun it is not when you say it is not. And the moon changes even as your mind. What you will have it named, even that it is. And so it shall be so for Catherine.
Forward! Forward! But soft, what company is coming here? Good morrow, gentle mistress. Where away? Tell me, sweet Kate, and tell me truly, too. Hast thou beheld a fresher gentlewoman? Such war of white and red within her cheeks? What stars do spangle heaven with such beauty as those two eyes become that heavenly face? Fair, lovely maid, once more good day to thee. Sweet Kate, embrace her for her beauty's sake.
Young, budding virgin, fair and fresh and sweet, whither away? Or where is thy abode? Oh, happy the parents of so fair a child. Happier the man whom favorable stars will allot for his lovely bedfellow.
Why, how now, Kate? I hope thou art not mad. This is a man. Old, wrinkled, faded, withered, and not a maiden as thou sayest he is.
Oh, pardon, old father, for my mistaking eyes that have been so bedazzled by the sun that everything I see is green and young. Now I perceive thou art a reverend father. Pardon, I pray thee, for my mad mistaking.
Pardon her, grandsire, and withal make known which way thou travelest. If along with us, we shall be joyful of thy company.
Fair sir, and you, my merry mistress, with your strange encounter much amazed me. My name is called Vincentio. My dwelling, Pisa.
Pisa, renowned for grave citizens, and bound I am to Padua, there to visit a son of mine, who long I have not seen. He studies at the university. His name is called Lucentio.
Husband, let's into my father's house.
First, kiss me, Kate, and we will.
What, in the midst of the street?
What, art ashamed of me?
No, sir, God forbid. But what a shame to kiss.
Why, then let's home again.
Nay, I will give thee a kiss. Now pray thee, love, stay.